Namaskar, welcome you all to an awesome lecture. Today we will study how do organisms reproduce. First let's define what do you mean by reproduction. Reproduction may be defined as the production of new generation of individuals of the same species. It's a classic definition of reproduction. Reproduction can be classified as two types. One is asexual reproduction and the other is sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, there is no involvement of sex organs or gametes. There is no fusion of gametes takes place in asexual reproduction, so there is no variation. Variation means change in the genetic material. It may be favorable variation or unfavorable variation. If the variation is favorable to an organism, it can cope up with the change in environment condition. Or if the variation is unfavorable, the organism may perish. It cannot cope up with the change in environment condition. Then sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, in this process, sex organs are involved, male sex organ and female sex organ. Gametes are involved, male gametes and female gametes. And the fusion of gametes takes place, formation of zygote takes place, mitotic division takes place, different types of cells are formed. Then cells form tissues, organs, organ systems like that. So in sexual variation, sexual reproduction, there is variation due to change in the genetic material. Asexual reproduction, it may be defined as the production of offsprings by a single parent. Here only one parent is involved and the organism produced will be the carbon copy of the parent, or we can call it as clone. This method of reproduction rapidly increases the number of offsprings under favorable condition, and due to repeated mitotic division. It occurs due to repeated mitotic division. Now, what do you mean by mitotic division? Mitotic division is a type of cell division. Cell division can be classified as two types. One is mitotic division or mitosis, or meiotic division or meiosis. In mitotic division, cell number increases. In meiotic division, it takes place only during the formation of gametes. And in mitotic division, the chromosome number will remain as same or as that of the parent cell. But in meiotic division, the chromosome number will be reduced into half. So meiotic division can be known as reduction division, and mitotic division is known as equational division. So because there is no change in the number of chromosomes, the young one receives all its gene from the parent in case of asexual reproduction. Types of asexual reproduction: fission means division. It can be two types, binary fission and multiple fission. Fragmentation, regeneration, budding, spore formation and vegetative propagation. These are the different types of asexual reproduction. Fission. It is the common method of asexual reproduction in unicellular organisms. One cell divides to form two cells. It involves the splitting of parent cell into two or more than two separate daughter organisms. In case of binary fission, one cell divides into two and form two daughter organisms. Example, amoeba, bacteria. Multiple fission, one cell divides to form many daughter organisms. For example, plasmodium. So in any division process, there are two steps. One is the division of nucleus. It's known as karyokinesis. And the other is division of cytoplasm. That's known as cytokinesis. So let's see the division in amoeba. Here you can see division of nucleus. Nucleus divides to form two, and cytoplasm divides and surround the nucleus, and two daughter organisms are formed. This is a classic example of binary fission. This is multiple fission, takes place in plasmodium. One nucleus divides to form many nuclei, and cytoplasm divides to form many and surround the nuclei and form many daughter organisms. And these all daughter organisms are enclosed in a thick wall. It's known as cyst wall. During favorable condition, this cyst wall breaks and daughter organisms are released. Fragmentation. When an organism attains maturity, it simply divides into many fragments, and each fragment develops to form new organisms. For example, in Spirogyra, when Spirogyra attains maturity, it divides to form many fragments, and each fragment develops to form new organisms. Spirogyra is also known as a filamentous algae, filament in shape. Regeneration. It is defined as the ability of an organism to regain its lost parts. So it's an ability of an organism, and it's also a mode of reproduction. It's a mode of reproduction in planaria. If the planaria is cut into many pieces and each piece develops to form new planaria. But it's an ability in case of lizard, world lizard. When you cut the tail of the lizard, the regeneration of tail takes place. So it's an ability and it's also a mode of reproduction. So this is a diagram showing the regeneration process in planaria. If planaria is cut into many pieces due to external force, and each piece developed to form new planaria. Budding. It may be defined as the production of new individual from an outgrowth of the parent individual. So here lateral buds are formed from base part of the hydra due to continuous mitotic division. And when the organism attains full maturity, it simply detaches from the parent body. So lateral buds forms in hydra, but in case of yeast, chain buds are formed. So this is the difference between budding process in yeast and hydra. In hydra, lateral buds are formed. In yeast, chain buds are formed. Spore formation. A spore is a single-celled reproductive structure that detaches from the parent body and gives rise to a new organism. And the spores are enclosed in a cup-shaped structure known as sporangium. Millions of spores are present inside the sporangium. When the sporangial wall breaks down, these spores are liberated outside, and when it falls on a moist surface, it forms new organism. For example, spore formation in rhizopus. So there are so many advantages if an organism reproduces to spore formation. First case, millions of spores are liberated. So there is no problem in reproduction. If one spore damages, another generate to form new organism. And it can also survive in harsh climatic condition. It will be in a dormant shape. So there is advantage in formation, spore formation process. Vegetative propagation. It's a method of asexual reproduction in which the parts other than seeds are used as propagules. Normally, seeds produce new organisms. In this process, other than seed like stem, leaf and root are used as propagules for the production of new organisms. In fact, it is a method of propagation in those plants which have lost their capacity to produce seeds or produce non-viable seeds. So some organisms cannot produce seeds, some plants cannot produce seeds. So how they reproduce? Using vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation through leaf, stem and root. And some plants produce non-viable seed. Non-viable seed means the seeds cannot germinate. So these plants can also reproduce through this vegetative propagation method. For example, banana, rose, pineapple and seedless grapes are produced in this way. Among the flowering plants, every parts of the plant body such as root, leaf, stem take part in vegetative propagation. This is an example. Buds are formed in the leaves of bryophyllum. So bryophyllum propagate through leaf. The vegetative propagules here is leaf. Now let's see what are the advantages of this vegetative propagation. This is very, very, very important. Flowers produced are superior quality. Desirable character of fruit can be maintained. So here desirable characters can be maintained. If parent having some desirable character, offspring also have. Plants that do not have viable seeds can be reproduced. Produce identical quality as parent, and it's very quick. It's a very fast method of reproduction. More plants can be produced in a very short span of time. Disadvantages of vegetative propagation. Plants can be easily decayed. If a plant is reproduced through this vegetative manner, it can be decayed very easily. The disease of parent plant are transferred to offspring. There is no genetic variation. So here variation does not take place. Plants are less adaptable to the environment. So if there is no variation, there is no formation of new characters, and there is no evolution process. Evolution takes place due to the accumulation of variation over time. So in these plants, there is no change or new characters are formed. So these are the limitations of the plants which are reproducing through vegetative propagation. So this is all about asexual reproduction in organisms. So next lecture, we will discuss about sexual reproduction. If you like this video, फिर देर किस बात की, मीठी मीठी तालियों के साथ लाइक सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग. हैप्पी लर्निंग एंड स्टे कनेक्टेड.